and 17, and Timmy and Caroline have become famous. Who knew? Tonight they are going to be on TV together, singing a duet. So Tim's old Sunday school class have decided to meet up at Duncan's house. They've also decided for a bit of fun and to come in fancy dress. Enjoy the show.
Banana, and it's not, because Tim gave it to me and he said lemon. And I had an argument and he won. Yeah, I did.
Few days, the Jews follow the two Christians. As Highfield Church is still being built.
I really have gone far back this time. I recognise that man from the photos in the church. He's the first minister of Highfield Road.
Your clothes are bad, you're dressed like a man.
I'm sorry.
That's okay, I understand, you're a pauper.
I'm Liz. What's your name?
My name is Margaret.
No way! You can't be!
Yes, I am! Now we have a word from Reverend Sturge.
The Japanese ran away!
Where would the Japanese go? I don't know, they seem to have gone off.
The Dutch army come in and rescue William!
I'm so happy for you, William!
Sorry, I'm a bit deaf now.
There he is!
I'm
off we go.
My song is...
I'm great.
One night a man had a dream. He dreamed he was walking along the beach with the Lord. Across the sky flashed scenes from his life. For each scene, he noticed two sets of footprints in the sand. One belonged to him and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of his life flashed before him, he looked back at the footprints in the sand. He noticed that many times along the path of his life, there was only one set of footprints. He also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in his life. This really bothered him, and he questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I've noticed that during the most troublesome times of my life, there is only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you the most, you would leave me. The Lord replied, my precious, precious child, I love you and would never leave you. During your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you.
He's got a limp! Hi, Andy. How's it going?
I've got a doctor's appointment tomorrow and I'm afraid it might need an operation.
Oh, that's too bad. I'll pray for you.
Thanks.
Yeah. He's got a limp! Oh, Andy! He's got a limp!
It's the wrong name.
That's a good point, Andy. Yeah, Andy.
Yeah?
How's it going?
Not good. I need the operation.
Oh, no!
Oh. Yeah. Well, a lot of people pray for me, but I think it's God's will.
Yeah, it must be.
Yeah.
I'll see you later, yeah?
We see Linda walking back home, alone, a little bit worse for wear.
Andy!
Yeah?
You're supposed to have a limp!
I shouldn't know that.
Andy's just shot her. Not so bad.
I'm okay! I am not dead. I am okay.
Not much longer.
Stabbing as well. Not good.
I'm still okay. Shh. Lots of people are all be fine.
Surely not. Sure. Where is it? Where's my weapon?
Moody, does your gang still help people?
No, that was only when we were young.
Please help me. My sister Gemma ran away, and I don't want to tell my parents on a treat like that.
Don't worry, we will help you. Guys, we have to get the BMDTTO back together again.
No way. Last time we helped people, nobody thanked us.
Jesus died on the cross for us. Who thanked him?
Okay, let's do it.
Save it, listen.
Oh, I love this song.
I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. Fishing the night away. Fishing the night away.
He drinks a vodka drink. He drinks a cider drink. Songs that remind him of the good times. He sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
Oh, Danny boy, Danny boy. I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. Down. And I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down. And I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, and I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down.
I'm sure I've seen you use under before. In my dream. Do you want to make it a reality? Sorry to bring you out here, but you know, I know food is a source of love.
Well, have you got a hot cross button?
Oh, because it's important to celebrate the real reason why we celebrate Easter. You know, Jesus dying on the cross and all that sort of thing.
Yeah, come on, my friends.
I know your family made us dating, but now I've heard your grandfather's will, I'll be honest with you, let's get married.
You money, Grandma!
I think that's the best thing you've ever done for me. And I think I'm in love with you.
I can give you plenty more where that came from.
Come on, we got a race to win. And why on earth are you reading that book?
But I'm reading from Matthew 13. What's that got to do with us getting a lot of money?
Thanks, Meg.
Oh, yes, please, mate.
A bit early for Halloween, love.
How are you? In the boat.
This has got everything to do with the money. That's the last thing a Bobo said on the DVD.
Well, who cares about that?
You don't understand. The Bible passage talks about people seeing but not really seeing and people hearing but not really hearing the right thing. Jesus talks through parables. The only people to understand the parables are the people who truly love him. I think the Bible was trying to tell us that he has never helped people with his money and he died rich but unhappy. Jesus offers us hope if we follow him. I think he's saying that whoever has this money should use it to help others.
Yeah? Well, I'm going to use that money to make myself happy, starting with a faster car.
I'm going as fast as I can, mate. The speed limit's 30.
Thank you. And may I say, it is good to have you all here today.
Oh,